Hello and welcome to the Hard Reset 2022 Gift Guide. Please like and subscribe so we can share this whole series with you. I'm Nick, I'm one of the co-creators of Hard Reset, and we put together this gift guide because as we research Hard Reset, we're constantly finding interesting products or ideas that we'd like to be able to share with people. Some of those make it into the show and some don't, but each of these products has been selected because we think, like all the Hard Reset topics we cover, that they invite you to rethink something in your life from the ground up. So stick around as we talk about each of these products. We're going to talk about our experiences with them and who we think they might be a good gift for. Also, keep watching to learn how you can win one of these awesome gifts. So we put together a gift guide. We're going to have five different episodes, one on food, one on learning, one on the metaverse, one on books, and one on personal technology. The first episode we're doing is all about food. So growing it, cooking it, eating it, and understanding it. And if you want to win one of these, leave us a comment down below that tells us which one of these you think will have the biggest impact on the world. We're going to pick our favorite comment from the top comments, and we're going to give that commenter probably one of these gifts. Well, this one, I think. Maybe not this exact one. We'll send you one from Amazon. We're not crazy. I've used this one, so you don't want it. Okay, let's get to the gifts. Food is a universal thing. We all eat. If you don't, you should try it. It will make you a lot less grumpy. We've covered a lot of different food topics on Hard Reset because how we grow and consume food is so impactful on our lives and on the world. So the first item that we're going to talk about is this indoor vertical garden. Yes, a home vertical garden. Now, we've covered vertical gardens on Hard Reset. They're usually big warehouses full of racks and racks of produce. This is one that you can actually have in your house. It's got little pods that you pop in, and then it uses AI to automatically water your plants and make sure they get the right amount of light. So even if you live in a tiny basement apartment that only gets direct sunlight from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. in the summertime, you can still grow your own lettuce and tomatoes and peppers and chives and cucumbers and mint. You get the idea. Why is this a Hard Reset gift? Well, we think that this is super cool for some of the same reasons we think commercial vertical farms are cool. Think about the vast amount of the Earth's surface that humanity has taken over to use for growing food. What if we could use less of the Earth's surface for growing food and distribute food production so that it's closer to where people consume it, like in urban areas or, with something like this, even inside people's homes? So there's big ecological benefits to this. It wouldn't hurt for everyone to be able to grow their own food at home. Eating more fresh vegetables is pretty much objectively good for you. And growing your own vegetables is a surefire way to make sure you eat more of them. For this product, we really love the overall design. It's pretty easy to build and set up, and it looks great as is. We haven't had it long enough to produce our first crop, but so far we love how it pretty much manages itself and lets you know when it needs something, or when the food is ready to be harvested. It's also a nice compact design. It only has about 2 square feet at the bottom that it needs, so you can fit it even in a small apartment. Now, this is not a small gift. The setup you see here costs about $850 just for the hardware. That's an investment. After that, you can either subscribe and they'll send you prepared pods with seeds in them, or you can source your own seeds and soil and grow them on your own. Either way, there are potential long-term savings compared to buying produce at retail prices, but it's definitely not a small purchase. So if you're going to get this for someone, make sure you really like them, maybe even love them. As for who to give this to, well, it's a great gift for someone like me, who likes the idea of growing their own food, but is really, really bad at taking care of plants. I cannot count how many of my wife's plants I've murdered, not out of malice, but sheer incompetence. An intelligent garden like this can make it easy for even someone like me to grow food. The next gift on our set is this molecular gastronomy starter kit. Now, if you're not familiar with molecular gastronomy, it's basically a Hard Reset for how we think about cooking. Molecular gastronomy is all about approaching the preparation of food through the lens of chemistry and physics, and being extremely precise about how you prepare your food in order to create very specific flavors and textures and experiences. Think about using, you know, liquid nitrogen to make ice cream out of avocados. I don't know, crazy shit like that. It's usually found in super high-end dining experiences. But anything that allows you to rethink something familiar from the ground up has Hard Reset written all over it. This is a super fun kit that makes it easy to dive in and try out some of these techniques. It comes with everything you need to get started, and it's a kind of a fun thing to do with your whole family. There's a kit for culinary experimentation as well as one for mixology and cocktails. As for how much it costs, you're looking at about $70, which is a lot cheaper than a meal at one of those fancy molecular gastronomy restaurants. We'd say it's a perfect gift for someone who has a culinary wild side and likes to cook. This could get them to break out that sous vide machine that you got them last year. The next thing I want to talk about is this. Apparently, you can buy home distilling kits, like on Amazon. I did not know that until we started putting this guide together. The reason I didn't think you could buy a still like this, and I want to be very clear about this, is because distilling liquor is like 1,000% illegal in the United States, without a permit from the Tax and Trade Bureau. So definitely don't do that, or encourage others to do it. That said, the hardware for distillation is totally legal and has a lot of totally fun legal uses. William Faulkner once said that civilization begins with distillation, and he was probably right in more ways than one. Distillation is one of the core technologies that has allowed human civilization to flourish. Of course, distilled liquor is mainly associated with its recreational or ceremonial uses, but it was also pretty important for purifying water and acting as an early sterilizing agent. So you can distill a lot more than just alcohol. You can also distill essential oils, and other things like that, or really just water. This kit is about $100, and it's pretty flexible. It's not super easy to set up because the instructions were really poorly translated. But figuring it out with a friend or family member is a great bonding experience. I tried it out by making distilled water. I took a small piece of the Pacific Ocean and distilled it down to pure water. What I was left with was salt, another cornerstone of civilization. And since it was ocean water, I guess there's probably some fish poop mixed in there. But still, get it? Still? This is a perfect gift for anyone who's interested in the science of food, cooking, or distillation. And also, this main pot can still be used for things like homebrewing, which is actually very legal. So this down here is Lomi, a little home composting unit. Basically, you put your food scraps and other compostable materials into it, and it turns it into dirt. On the surface, it might seem strange that you need an appliance to turn home food scraps into dirt, but composting is actually pretty complicated. Different temperatures and oxygen levels can impact which microbes thrive. And the Lomi manages all of that by breaking food down and controlling the temperature and moisture levels inside. There's huge conservation benefits to this, and we think it's a hard reset for how we think about our waste. Lomi is helping people capture value from their waste, getting us closer to a circular economy. So if you lived on a colony on Mars, you'd never dream of wasting your food scraps by burying them in a landfill somewhere. You'd be cycling all your scraps back into new food. We don't currently live on Mars, but there's no reason to think differently about our waste. I love the design and the simplicity of Lomi, and it's super easy to use. The output is also super awesome. You're basically making really good dirt that you can use in your own garden, maybe even in your own home vertical garden. So the molecules and nutrients that we're able to preserve from this can have real lasting impact and even feed us down the line. Lomi is not super cheap. It's $500, and it's definitely a gift for someone who's close to you, but it's a perfect gift for anyone who's interested in gardening or looking to reduce the amount of waste they put out. It's also fun for families to learn about how these processes work and how our food economy impacts our lives and the world. So in full disclosure, Lomi did provide this unit to us to test and evaluate. Now, that didn't change our evaluation or our review or recommendation. And any problems we have with it, we would have let you know, but we really do just think it's a cool product. This imposing book is Modernist Cuisine at Home by the folks at the Cooking Lab founded by Nathan Myhrvold. You might know Mr. Myhrvold from his involvement in a lot of patent lawsuits, but he's also done amazing things in the world of cookbooks. Now, the first cookbook that he came out with was called Modernist Cuisine. It was a 5-volume book, cost about $500, I want to say, and it was incredibly beautiful. But this is a more affordable and approachable book that they put out recently. It's not like a condensed version of the bigger one. They actually have original content for this and its own thing. So it's definitely a worthwhile investment. It is expensive. It's about $80. But it's a really, really lush book. I love poring over the photographs and learning about how food works at the molecular level, like really understanding how we cook from the ground up. One of the most amazing things they do in this is they're constantly doing cross sections of things. So they'll cross-sect a bowl of salad so you can see how things work. They do this with appliances so you can see how mixers work or how heat spreads across the surface of a wok or a frying pan. These cross-sections really make visual some things that we've always sort of understood intuitively about cooking, but never really had a visual way of seeing. I highly recommend this book. pick one up for someone in your life who likes to cook, and probably a good idea to get it for someone who will cook for you. Also, make sure that they have room in their library. It's not small. It's large enough to stun a burglar with or crush a small animal. So the last item in this episode is more of a stocking stuffer gift. These are compostable straws from New Light Technologies made using AirCarbon. We actually covered this company for one of our other series, and we love what they're doing. Basically, they're taking carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and using it to create biomaterials that act like plastics, but will still compost in nature. We also love their cutlery, and they even make plates. But the straws are really the thing. I cannot tell you how sick I am of paper straws. They're fine in an emergency, but you cannot drink a milkshake through a paper straw before it completely falls apart. And if you drink the milkshake fast enough that the straw doesn't fall apart, then you're going to get a terrible ice cream headache, which nobody wants. And metal straws are not a lot better. They're a pain to wash and they hurt your teeth. Now, my concerns on this topic are totally frivolous. But for people with disabilities, the bans on plastic straws can have a very serious impact on their quality of life. The reason I think this is a hard reset is because we need to think differently about our waste products. Just like we need to compost more, we can think about things like carbon dioxide as a resource. We can use it to make things of value. Instead of just treating it as a pollutant, maybe we should treat it as a commodity. But innovations like AirCarbon mean that we can have the upsides of plastic straws without destroying the planet. These are available at Target online for about $3 a box, and they're also used by some restaurant chains. You can give them to anyone who wants to take their time enjoying their milkshake. So we hope you enjoyed this episode on food. Food is one of the most important things in our lives. It literally is what makes up our whole bodies. That's kind of weird. I'm made up of a lot of hamburgers and milkshakes. Ooh. Anyway, so a gift that opens up someone's eyes to the possibilities of eating differently could literally change who they are from the molecule up. Come back for our other episodes on learning, the metaverse, personal tech, and books. And make sure that you like and subscribe so that we can keep you in the loop and share more news and stories about people and ideas that are changing the world. Laura, do you want to buy any of these gifts?
No.
I didn't convince you? Let's go ahead and cut.